Good morning, neighbors. I'm going to sing a Southern gospel classic, I Can't Even Walk Without You Holding My Hands. I thought that number one would surely be me. I thought I could be what I wanted to be. I thought I could build on life's sinking sand, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Oh, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, that's where I learn to stand. For I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I thought I had done a lot on my own. I thought I could make it all alone. I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand. No, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, that's where I learn to stand. For I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Amen. Song was written about, I think it was around 8 years before I was born, 1973. And a lot of people have covered it. Me, myself, and I like to hear Charles Johnson and the Revivers sing it. But I always like that part where it really, it's a very humbling song, of course, because just like a child, or really a very small child, they can't walk without some kind of security of something holding on to them and helping them walk. And that's really, we are all just children of God. And he said you really have to remain with that kind of spirit. That unless you become like a little child, you can't enter in, because it's going to take a complete trust in the Lord that you can hold on to him, but really he's holding on to you. You know, a child may be proud of themselves. They're smiling real big as they're taking some steps while they're holding on to their parents' fingers. But we know who really has the control. You're helping them balance. You're helping them move. You're helping them build their muscles. And that's what really the song, I believe, is talking about. But I do think I thought number one would surely be me. I thought I could be what I wanted to be. Even as a Christian, sometimes you can be like, man, I'm doing, you know, look at all the things I'm doing, and yet we really live on a razor's edge. It's only him keeping us. Our next breath is in his hands. The fact that we can move and do all these things. And I thought of myself as a mighty big man. And again, out in sin, that's what we think. And sometimes even our Christian walk, you know what, I'm pretty spiritual. Oh, I'm humble. You know, you'll hear people, oh, I'm pretty humble. It's like, well, if you're acknowledging your humility, then you're not a very humble person. But I really wanted to focus on the fact that it says, down on my knees, I learned to stand. And it's really the Christian's total dependence on prayer and trusting in the Lord. You know, Lord, can you do this? Help me. And I've had conversations with people, and they just look at their prayer life and say, it's so weak. It's not, you know, I don't even know what to say. I don't know what to do. And I thought, I've been reading in Romans chapter 8, in verse 26, it says, likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses. For we do not know what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. You know, and we'll just continue reading. Now he who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And when I read that the other day, it really gave me a sense of peace, because sometimes you can get on your knees and say, where do I even begin? And of course, we do speak and we do ask the Lord things, and we thank him for all that he's done. You know, that the disciples asked Jesus, how teach us how to pray. And of course, he teaches them what we call the Lord's Prayer. But I like this because it says it helps in our weaknesses. Wherever you're weak at, if your prayer life, if you consider it weak, you know, if you come in his name, it helps. The Spirit will help you. It doesn't, you know, we think sometimes in big, beautiful words or something, like we have to get on our knees and say, speak like William Shakespeare. But it just says, you know, it helps in our weakness. For we do not know what we should pray for as we ought. Lord, how do I even ask this? You know, Lord, can you just help me? I don't even know what to pray. I don't even know to pray how I should be praying. You know, what do I ask for? Do I even ask for this? And but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. You know, it goes beyond. The Spirit will take. He looks into the depths of our heart and sees our need and how, you know, we like Jesus. We want to be like Jesus. Not my will, but thine be done, Lord. You know, you see my the desires of my heart. And he says he hears and he listens. And because he who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. So when we get down on our knees to pray, it's just a personal relationship. It doesn't have to be some beautiful, glorious words, you know, because sometimes you get on your knees and pray, it's like, my goodness, it's like Jesus is sitting here right next to me. Other times it seems like, is he even listening? But we know this, he's there and he's listening and he hears our heart's cry. He loves to hear the needs of his people. He loves that you're coming to him in confidence and in trust. And oftentimes I see with myself, if I pray out loud, it seems to help me keep my mind straight. And as you're talking to the Lord and giving him thanks and praise, and like Jesus said, you know, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. You know, help us to forgive others just as we've been forgiven. Thank you for providing for our needs, you know, our daily bread and things like this. And I really like, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. You know, he just gives, you know, it always returns back to the Heavenly Father. You know, thank you, you're so great for all that you've done. And our simple little words may not seem like much. How can we offer this to a mighty God? But it's something that he asks and it's something he enjoys. And I pray that we can find enjoyment in that. So down on your knees, that's where you'll learn how to stand. So God bless you all. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.